In part one, we configured a variable frequency drive, or a VFD, so we could control it over the network. There may be installs where you want to do the configuration and status over the network, but prefer to do the actual drive control via external inputs. How do you do that? Well, it's easy. Just go up here to the hardware configuration, select the VFD, and go to the digital tab. Parameter 3.00 selects the source of control. A 0 says use the keypad that's on the drive. 1 and 2 say use the external inputs on the drive, which you can control with manual switches or even digital I.O. from the control if you want to. And 3 and 4 say take all the commands from the network like we have been doing. The stop in here is referring to the stop button on the keypad. You can enable or disable the keypad stop button. If you select an external source, let's say number 1 right here, which says use the external source with the stop button on the keypad enabled, now you have to tell it how to configure the I.O.s. You do that with the parameter 3.01. Do we want a separate forward and reverse control, or do we want a run switch with a separate switch that controls forward and reverse? Or do we want a run switch with a forward reverse switch with a stop switch? Let's go ahead and select number 1 with forward and reverse on the same switch. Well, that's all there is to manually controlling the GS Series motor drive. Now you can configure and monitor the drive over the network, but control it via external inputs. And of course, if you're controlling it via external inputs, you no longer need your GS drive write because you're not controlling it from the network. The nice thing about controlling the drive over the network is you only have 2 possible failure points: the network connection between the controller and a GSE drive, and the 485 connection between the GSE drive and the VFD. And the Productivity 3000 makes it easy to monitor, diagnose, and gracefully control the motor shutdown should either of them fail. How do you monitor the health of the connection with discrete wiring? Well, you can't until the failure actually occurs. With a network connection, that link can be constantly monitored so you know if there's an issue before it's needed. Here's how. One way is to simply monitor the status bits in each GS write and GS read instruction. For example, if you set up a tag to monitor the timeout status right here, and you get a timeout error, well, you can react accordingly in your ladder code. The other method is to use the communications heartbeat. To get this set up, you have to configure the drive by setting parameters 903 to determine how the drive will react, 904 to enable this feature, and 905 to set a timeout. If we go over here and look at our hardware configuration, you'll notice that parameter set 9, 6, 7, 8 doesn't exist. You actually have to do that on the drive itself. You can't do it from the configuration menu here. So again, set up parameters 903, 4, and 5 to determine how the drive will react in the event of a timeout. Next, you need to make sure that your GS drive write or read are set up with a polling time that's faster than the timeout you just set in parameter 905. It's this polling that the drive's looking for. If it doesn't see this within that timeout that you set in parameter 905, then it will react accordingly. Finally, you want to use a GS drive read to monitor parameter 2201 right here. You define a tag for that and watch that in your ladder code, and that'll tell you if the link between the GSE drive and the VFD is solid or not. So by using these features, you can assure yourself of a solid, robust install that will tell you when there's a problem and help you diagnose it. In the previous video, we set the run and the jog commands to constants. This was 55 Hertz and 10 Hertz. You can also use tags here. I've created a tag called run frequency. Let me put that in here. So now in my ladder code, if I change the value of run frequency and the instructions enabled via the auto run, then the drive will react accordingly on the very next polling cycle. It'll ramp up or down to the new frequency per the ramp rates I defined in my configuration. These mode tables that you see in the GS read and GS write instructions give you a convenient place to change the GS drive parameters on the fly. If you enable run mode data, then any parameter that's defined anywhere in this run mode table with either a tag or a constant over here will be written to the drive. Parameters that are not defined will not be written. This is great because it means you can update just a few parameters anytime you want without having to send the whole table. Note that this is an edge-triggered thing, so only one set gets sent each time this rung is turned on. Note that the run mode table only has parameters that can be used while the motor is running, and the stop mode table only has parameters that can be used while the motor is stopped. This makes things easy for you. No more guessing. You set the rate at which drives get updates while the GS drive read or write is active here. This polling offset allows you to space out communications to different drives to help improve the performance and minimize congestion on the network. For example, suppose we have 5 drives and we're polling them every 100 milliseconds. Consider having the first drive delay at 0, the next drive at 20 milliseconds, the next drive at 40 milliseconds, the next one at 60 milliseconds, the next one at 80 milliseconds. That way they're evenly spaced out and it'll help reduce congestion on your network traffic. Well, we hope you find the tidbits in this video helpful as you use the VFDs with the Productivity 3000. As you can see, the Productivity 3000 is set up to make your job easy. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more ways to get up and running quickly with this controller. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Performance plus value. That's productivity from Automation Direct.